Josh Jackson of the Phoenix Suns has been accused of getting his 4-month-old daughter high on marijuana. This comes just 1 month after he was arrested for running away from a police officer at the Rolling Loud Music Festival. And for the cherry on top of the bad news sundae, the Suns are looking to trade him. Let's dive into this story. What's up, everyone? It's Devin Howard. Before we get into the Josh Jackson news, come say hi to me on Instagram at Devin Howard, then subscribe to the Fumble, tap the bell for notifications, and click that thumbs up button. All right, so let's break down this shocking story. Josh Jackson is in some hot water after reports surfaced that claimed he got his 4-month-old daughter high from marijuana, unintentionally. In court documents, the child's mother accuses Josh of getting his daughter high. Apparently, she began noticing a pattern of behavior when she'd drop off their baby girl at his house. Whenever she would meet up with him, the child's mother claimed that Josh always smelled of marijuana. And finally, one day, after their daughter spent around 8 hours at Josh's house, she was very lethargic and couldn't fully open her eyes. The court doc says, quote, "After the child did not move for a long period of time, mother forced the child to wake up. The child appeared to be high and could only lift her eyelids to a midway point. The child's behavior was not the norm for her personality." A week later, the mother texted Josh and accused him of smoking around their child and getting her high. He denied it all, saying he only smoked when his kid isn't around, which also isn't a good look for him either, considering marijuana is a prohibited substance for NBA players even in the off season. So no matter which way you slice it, this doesn't seem to end very well for Josh, and it doesn't exactly challenge his already poor reputation. Last month, the NBA player attended the Rolling Loud Music Festival in Miami. While there, he reportedly tried to enter the VIP area numerous times, even though he didn't have the correct pass. Obviously, he was turned away over and over again, and it became such a nuisance that he was arrested. The cops handcuffed him, but before they could escort him out of the festival, he took off running. He was caught eventually and was arrested and charged with resisting arrest and escape at the music festival. Then, flashing back to 2 years ago, the athlete got in some legal trouble in 2017 after he and a teammate were charged with vandalism. The two were accused of damaging his teammate's ex-girlfriend's car. Josh pled not guilty to the charges, but then eventually made a diversion agreement and was ordered to take part in an anger management course. And now, to top it all off, the Phoenix Suns have been discussing trade packages that include Josh Jackson and TJ Warren, as well as the number 6 pick. In the last season, Jackson didn't improve as much as the team anticipated and actually fell behind some of his other teammates. Because of that, the Suns are willing to part ways with him. Kelly Oubre Jr. is a restricted free agent this summer, and moving off of the $35.1 million TJ Warren is due over the next 3 seasons could free up some cap space to keep Oubre if he ends up signing a lucrative offer sheet. Bottom line here is Jackson is expendable, and he'll probably find himself suiting up for another team for the 2019-2020 season. The Suns could package the number 6 pick and either Warren or Jackson to move up in the draft and find a point guard of the future, maybe Darius Garland or Kobe White. One of those players could drop to them at number 4, especially because other teams like the Knicks, Pels, and Cavs all have young point guards, but we also have to remember that other teams could trade ahead of them and snag their top choice. In another situation, the Suns could just offload Warren and Jackson's salaries to keep Oubre, like I mentioned before, and then also add a point guard in free agency. If Kyrie signs with the Nets, something we talked about here in the Fumble earlier today, the Suns could have their sights set on someone like D'Angelo Russell. Regardless, like I said before, Josh Jackson will probably be getting the boot from his team and possibly the NBA if he doesn't get his act together. What do you think about this news? Do you believe he really did unintentionally get his daughter high? What will happen with him next season? Sound off in the comments, click subscribe, and check back here later for more sports news.